Here, where there is not a lake, river, or stream for hundreds of miles, there are small openings in the jungle called cenotes. Sources of water that could support whole cities. No wonder the Maya attributed a spiritual power to their mysterious underground water source. Camila Haber has her own special relationship with the Maya's underwater world. She's a free diver. She's actually Mexico's national record holder. She went down deep.
56 meters, no fins.
On a single breath.
Yeah.
For a long time.
It means it's a dive of around 2 minutes and 30 seconds, more or less. Up and down. Down and up. I grew up diving in the cenotes, so I go back very often. For the Mayan culture, it was a portal to another world where the souls went, and they were used for sacrifices, asking for rain from the gods, and it was a sacred place.
If you want to access this world, you have to dive 200 feet down on a single breath, which is incredible, but that's what freedivers do. And if that wasn't enough, today, Camila plans to dive into this eerie, toxic cloud at the bottom of the cenote.
Frankly speaking, this is the most worrying thing we can encounter cave diving.
Vincent is accompanying Camila as a safety diver.
This is visually beautiful, but it's pretty toxic. It has exactly the same effect as carbon monoxide. So it's not really a good thing to be swimming in for ages.
Someone tell that to Camila.
Looks more like dancing underwater than swimming. I'm not really worried for her, as long as she's not staying very long in the hydrogen sulfide.
Going through the layer, oh my God, this is so weird because it all goes dark. You don't know where you are. It's a very weird feeling because it's just kind of a cloud. And on the way up, you're swimming in this light beam, and it looks like there's something magical happening.